Word of caution, if it's a mainstream media site or a video channel that talks about health information, be very cautious because most of the time they're filled with a whole lot of inaccurate information or total misinformation. Hey there, NJRoute22.com here with another low carb keto carnivore chat. And today it's just a really quick public service announcement. It's about mainstream media or popular websites or video channels or magazines that talk about your health. We've noticed, and this is just a trend, I'm not going to be able to lay it out in some sort of scientific way, but anytime a publication becomes popular or is popular and they talk about health, you gotta watch out because there's most of the time you're gonna have detrimental effects if you follow their advice. I just stumbled across this one video channel. I forget the name of it, but it's part of this Galvanized Media group. And as you can see here from their little image, they have two guys eating sandwiches. That right there is a flag alone. You shouldn't be eating bread at all if you wanna have good health. And they're just pushing like a narrative that benefits their sponsors and advertisers and doctors and everybody else that supports the sick people out there. And we noticed this. We're going to do a little story about this later on about there's this actual magazine called Diabetic Living. And I got to find another copy. I was flipping through an issue from like 5 years ago and they just promote carbs. I mean, how could a diabetic magazine do that? And I guess these diabetics who are living with this condition are tempted, and they want to believe that these recipes for stuffing for Thanksgiving and other stupid stuff that they'll just never give them up. So they're conned. It's a big con. So now there are some mainstream sites that, or not mainstream, I should say, popular sites that do peddle or have good information, and they're far and few between, and they're intermingled and mixed in with a whole lot of other popular sites. And a lot of the reason, like a lot of these popular sites get popular, I said popular, how many times? Because they have money, investment money in them, and they have staff to populate their keywords, and they're constantly manning multiple social media channels, and they probably hired a company to help them get ranked higher. And it's all artificial growth, but in the beginning, and then they get followers, and they have a million people subscribed to their channel, and they can sail smooth from there. But you need a lot of money, which independent vloggers and bloggers like us do not have. We start from the bottom and we're held back. We're absolutely held back. So if you're one of the few people that see this and realize, you gotta tell your friends, don't read this crap. As good as it sounds or as sexy or good looking or in shape these presenters are, it's not the truth, okay? So have a good week ahead.